and welcome to Italy for day two of the Shotgun World Championships from Trapconca Verde in Lonato. It's been a glorious day here in northern Italy, and for six shooters, well, it might get better still. They are the men who have made it to the trap final and who have a chance of being crowned world champion. And four out of the six have been world champions or are the world champion. And all of these athletes have already qualified for Rio. Two athletes winning the two quota places today, the rest already qualified. So it's all set for a fabulous, fabulous day for the finals of the trap men competition here at the World Championship. We were hoping to get Peter Wilson, the Olympic double trap champion, who's been coaching one of the British team. He's gone AWOL, so I'm very pleased to say we have Fiammetta Rossi, daughter of Luciano, of course, the Italian Shooting Federation president, and part of the junior trap event yesterday. How did it go?
Yeah, not so good, because the range is really difficult and also the target. But I'm happy to stay here, enjoy everything, and I'm fine.
Yeah, it's certainly a lovely venue, and we've been made very welcome. And we are just about to get ourselves introduced to these six athletes who have fought through qualification. No shoot-off today. There were shoot-offs for both the women senior and junior yesterday, but now we can meet these athletes. Just to let you know that the two qualification places being explained to the crowd here, very good crowd, Maxime Motte of Belgium and Khaled Al-Madaf of Kuwait. So they have booked their place to Rio, but who will be world champion? That is the question that we have to answer here. So then, these are our six athletes. In shooting position one, we have Eric Varga of Slovakia, and he's been a world champion at junior and senior level. In fact, he is the current world champion after triumphing in Granada last year. And he's going to get a big round of applause, this man. Home favourite, possibly favourite full stop. He's a four-time world champion, a double Olympic silver medalist. That's just to mention a few of his achievements. Giovanni Pellielo of Italy. As you can see, Saturday afternoon, a lot of people here to watch. And this is Khaled Al-Mudaf. He's been shooting for 21 years, was world champion in 2002. Question is, can he stand on top of that podium again? Well, it's not been a long commute for this man, Stefano Salva, the man from San Marino, the world ranked number 31, has an impressive CV, never managed a medal in any event, and that's something that could change here today. This is the man with the other Olympic qualification place, the quota place. Maxime Motte placed 88th at last year's World Championship. So whatever happens here, he's had a pretty good day. Can he claim his first senior medal? This is our Spanish contestant, the last of our athletes, Alberto Fernandez, the man from Madrid, world champion in 2010, the world ranked number 21, also a double World Cup winner, qualified first with 123, that was more than two more than anybody else. So those are our six finalists, and I don't know, Fiammetta, if you have anybody you feel may possibly... I know you'll be probably backing the Italians, of course.
I think it will be a really amazing semi-final.
I know that a lot of athletes like this this finals area, because it is actually a very good and very tight release of clays. I don't know if you, it's something that you enjoy as well.
Yeah, I think it's nice, but it's so difficult for the people that enter with the highest score. It's so difficult to stay in the first position, because who knows what happened in 15 targets.
Yeah, absolutely, and I'm sure you know that it's a mind game as well as a game of hand-eye coordination and skill.
Let's start with an amazing central target.
Just to let you know, if you're new to the sport in trap, the semi-final, as you can see, 15 targets shot in three sections of five.
Oh, and, zero.
And this, for the home favourite straight away. Not a great start for Pellielo. Here's Amadov of Kuwait, the man who got one of those qualification places. Now Salva, San Marino, not too far away, of course, a lot of San Marino athletes here.
I think we have to both the quota, please. I think, I'm not sure.
Motte is the other man who got the quota place. Everyone in this final will be at Rio, so it's a high quality field. The sun is shining, low 20s. It's certainly a lot brighter than it was towards the end of yesterday when the junior men were in, it wasn't complete darkness, but it was very, very gloomy. Better from Pellielo, the only man to have missed in that first series of shots, that first round. And from Kuwait, looking pretty composed as well. And for a small country, San Marino, really good heritage in shooting.
Yeah, really, really good. We have to say that this round, number 6 here in Lonato, is really, really difficult. Target is not slowly, it goes so fast.
I think some like it, don't they, like that, and some prefer it to be a little slower in release, not so sharp.
But this is a world championship, so it's good.
And it is the same, of course, for everybody. And it'll just put into some people's hands. That's a nice, easy shot for the Italian, straight down the middle. And the man from Kuwait City.
Nope.
And that's our second miss of this competition. The conditions a little windier than they were yesterday. The flags round by the presentation area. Just a little more away from the flag post.
Oh,
Motte.
That's good.
Who really is uncharted territory to the world rank 57. Silver in the European Championships, what was that, 7 years ago in the Junior Europeans. Varga, first miss from him. Our referee, by the way, just to introduce him, is Yanakis Herakidis of Cyprus. Our jury member is Yunag Batakarka of Thailand. They're the men who have to make sure that everything goes the way it should do. Second miss for the Kuwaiti, who is at bottom of the pile at the moment. Salva going along very nicely at the moment, as is the Belgian as well. If you can get to the end of the first series and have 5 out of 5, you're in with a chance, and you're also in with a good rhythm, aren't you? It is all about rhythm.
So there is 3 shooter with 4.
Yep, it's Salva, Motte, Fernandez.
One, Lilo with the miss the first one, and Kuwait missed the target.
How much, as an Italian, are you enjoying seeing high-level shooting in your home country?
It's difficult because, you know, it's a world championship at home. So everybody's watching you. They think that it's more easy, but it's not true. It's
probably
more
harder, isn't it?
Yeah, it's harder. Miss for Salva.
That's his first miss for the San Marino athlete. It's very tight still. Mm-hmm. And we saw shoot-offs yesterday. And we'll probably see shoot-offs here as well. But at the moment, there is clear water for the gold medal matches. And that's Fernandez and Motte, both with a good 5 out of 5. Pellielo and Salva and Varga not far behind. And even Al Mudaf of Kuwait, not out of it yet. There's still 10 targets to go.
Everything can happen in 10 targets.
Absolutely.
And all the shooters know that.
Ready? Little pause whilst we get ourselves ready again. Remember, top two will go into the gold medal match. Next two into the bronze medal match. And we drop the bottom two, who will be 5th and 6th and stay 5th and 6th. Here is Pellielo, the weight of the home nation, and that's another miss.
Miss.
A He'll be desperate to be in the gold medal match. So will the majority of the, I think it's fairly thousands of people who are here. That was a difficult one, low and to the left for the QSC. Oh, and that one should have been a little bit easier for Salva, who has now missed a couple in a row. Two in a row missed for Salva, still on four.
Nice shot.
But Mote is looking good. The man from Belgium, Fernandez, his first miss, looking even better for Mote at the moment, who is one ahead on six. As we head into the next round of shooting. There we can see the seventh round of shooting, that one veering away to the right. Of course, five stations here, and round about now you're starting to work out what the rest will be.
Yeah.
One to the left, one to the right, one straight on from each station for these athletes. It's a glorious day here, and these athletes will tell you they prefer the sun on their backs. A little bit of forecast possibly tomorrow for the double trap for rain. We'll have to keep our fingers crossed for that. Mote looking very good, and Fernandez back
really
on it again.
Really good, really nice shot.
Flew away to the right, and the hand has gone up here.
Well.
And the Italian Pellielo, his gun was starting to be raised, and it's gone back.
I think the coach is not happy.
Back down again. And there's a conversation between.
Who think it was good, and who think it was wrong?
Chatting to the, I think Yossi feels he got a hit. They're talking to the two referees with the flags. Far side where we are. Referee is German, and I think that will stay as a miss. Difficult here for Pellielo, who had to, he's starting himself into his rhythm, had to stop and wait. So I guess as an athlete in shooting, you have to be prepared just to reset.
It's not easy. When something happens and you have to wait before shooting, destroy yourself.
Mote, the Belgian athlete, flag on his ear defenders, and he's doing his country proud at the moment. Still time for it to go wrong, but he is one ahead of Fernandez, and Fernandez is one ahead as we go into this next series of four athletes, so it's still very tight. Pellielo, not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Could have a three-way shoot-off to see who goes into gold and bronze medal matches. We'll talk you through it if it happens. Two Olympic quota places settled, so that's not something playing on the minds of these athletes at the moment. They're all going. They all know they're on the way to Rio next year. Mote, he's looking good, isn't he? He was here ever so early. Probably 40 minutes before the final, just sitting away to our left-hand side, just taking it in. I think that's a very sensible thing to do, because there are people coming very early. I mean, the place was full perhaps half an hour before, and now it's full to overflowing. I know you're having to stand a little way back before we hauled you into the commentary position. Yeah. It's good to see so many people here.
It's full of people. And it's good to see that the people is watching the shooting round and the shooting competition is amazing.
Yeah, it's a lot of interest here, not just shooters here today, being the weekend. A lot of people come up just to just enjoy the afternoon's events, not just the shooting here, but all the activities going on behind us. And this is great from Mote.
Oh,
he has shot so well and looks so calm, doesn't he? The 24-year-old from St. Hubert. Second miss from the Spaniard. And, Mote looking very, very comfortable at the moment. Two ahead of three athletes, Fernandez, Pellielo and Varga. Salva will still be hoping he can get into the medal matches. And a little bit of drift now. Al-Madaf of Kuwait, two away from being in contention for the medal matches. And we have five more targets, and everything can change in an instant.
Of course, everything can change. And all the shooter know, because in every competition happens something like that. Who's in the top can miss one target and lose everything.
So Varga of Slovakia, the 39-year-old, starts us off with a hit in his 11th shot. Pellielo, feeling the pressure, the home man. He has won absolutely everything. 10 World Cup golds, 7 World Cup final golds. World Championships 4 times.
Another miss.
Another miss for
it's not a good
from
moment
Kuwait.
For him, I think.
No, I think Al Modaf has resigned himself to the fact that he's not going to make it to the medal matches. I think we might well have a shoot-off, at least one, you never know, possibly two. Ooh, and a miss, the first
miss.
One. Now then, will that play on his mind, or can he just put it away?
Oh.
And is that a miss as well? I think it is for Fernandez. Goodness me, everyone's starting to stumble. Only 3 out of 6 hitting that round of shots. And
what happened?
Varga with a, well, a miss.
What?
This is it was such good quality shooting to begin with, but at the moment it's all become a little bit difficult.
Yeah.
Al Modaf would like to finish strongly here, and that's better.
Nice shot.
Stefano Sella from San Marino. He's certainly in the mix at the moment. And this is the man who had his first miss.
Oh, again.
And another miss. Well, we said everything could change in the last five. And I just wonder whether it's playing on his mind more than perhaps it should do. Varga.
I think sometimes it's better if we don't speak.
Well, yeah, it's known as the commentator's curse, but certainly not speaking isn't an option, unfortunately. Although the athletes may wish we did. Here's Al Modaf.
Sorry.
No, I know what you're saying. That's a nice way to come towards the end of his 15 shots. He looks a bit of rhythm now. Selva certainly has rescued his afternoon. Now then, Mote, all eyes on him, and he knows it as well. That's better.
Yeah, he's back.
He is back. He is at the moment tied with Pellielo. And that will be the gold medal match, unless something changes. There's a three-way tie at the moment for the bronze medal match, so there may be a shoot-off there. And we're away again already. 13th round of shooting. Just one more after the guys have finished this rotation. Well, Raf will be hoping like he's much more on it now. It will feel a bit better, I'm sure. Selva, a little twitch as he went left.
Miss.
And a miss. He didn't enjoy that.
I think the
hand has gone up late. I think it's that Selva, isn't it? Now then, he's having a... He thinks he hits it. I think, again, going to talk to the two referees with the flags.
I think it's zero. But
who helped the Cypriot referee. Second time in this match we've had to have a check.
Because the light is not so good now. So you can see perfect the target when it's moving. It's difficult, really difficult.
The light is pretty good, isn't it? The sun is going down to our left, making it increasingly difficult.
And now there is a left target.
Oh!
Well, he's finished much, much stronger. If he can just get the last one, he should be in the gold medal match.
Yeah. Last target for everybody.
Well, that's miss from Selva has put him into fifth place. So, like you say, into the last target. Varga bags that one. Should be good enough for a bronze medal match. Pellielo.
Yeah.
Round of applause from the Italian
Johnny
crowd.
The
he should be into the gold medal match.
Gord.
I know that you'll be happy to see that. Here's Alan Badaf. He's finished well, hasn't he? Had a bit of a struggle throughout, but finished with 4 on the trot. Selva. He wasn't happy with the miss last time.
No.
Now then, Mote this one to put into the gold medal match. And he knows it. Can he calm those nerves? Oh, it's a miss. Gosh. It's a miss. Oh, my word. Well, we could have a three-way shoot-off.
Oh, my God.
Yes, we have. Because Fernando nails it. And Motte, who was two ahead with two-thirds of this match gone. Well,
it was an amazing semi-final, really.
Yeah, it certainly was. It was full of surprises. And Motte, well, let's hope he can regroup for the shoot-off, because he will have to shoot on against two others. Let's just confirm how it's finished. Alan Madaf takes sixth. Stefano Selva of San Marino, that contested miss, has to settle for fifth. A three-way shoot-off then between Fernandez, Motte and Varga, and Pellielo already has booked his place into the gold medal match. Well, we know he's done everything. He's hugely experienced. I mean, you must know the guy as well, and he has a good temperament.
Yeah, that is really interesting, because there is Fernandez is a really good shooter.
Well, Fernandez, Motte and Varga, we have a bit more work to do before they know which of the medals they are going to be in. So we're just about ready. Big round of applause for the Italian. Three men making it to the shooting positions again.
Our legend.
Your legend. I like the. Yeah, well, he is, isn't he? I mean, let's have a look. Let's go through the roll of honour for Giovanni Pellielo. Two silver medals at the Olympic Games, Beijing and Athens.
Yeah,
four golds, two silvers, and two bronzes in the World Championships. And, well, either a gold or a silver to add. The World Cup final, seven golds, five silvers, two bronzes. European Games, of course, just gone. He won the gold at the European Games, and of course, not to mention the 10 golds in the World Cup that he has won. And that's before you mentioned the European Championships as well. So we'll put him to one side for the time being. I'm sure you won't mind. Varga, Motte and Fernandez. Those are the two.
Now we have to shoot a left target.
Sorry?
Now we have to shoot a left target.
Yeah, it's a little bit more predictable in the shoot-off, isn't it?
And you take it?
Just remember, if you miss and the others hit, then you're the first person to leave. And what will happen is the first two who drop out will be in the bronze medal match, and the last athlete standing, so to speak, will end up in the gold medal match. So it is a sudden death. Each round counts.
Oh dear,
a miss from Motte. That's hard to cope with, isn't it? So then, Fernandez, if he hits, no, he's missed as well. So I think we've sorted out already, haven't we?
Yeah.
It's Varga who will go into the gold medal match.
With Giovanni.
And Motte and Fernandez having missed a very quick shoot-off, wasn't it? And so, yeah, it's interesting, isn't it? It's certainly a local final, Slovakian rather, against Italy, and then the bronze medal match, Belgium against Spain. So that's how it's worked out. It took just three shots to sort out that shoot-off, and in trap, certainly that doesn't happen very often, does it?
No, never.
Well, it's so crowded that, in fact, gold medal match athletes have just park themselves on a chair in front of us, which is nice to see. Pellielo chewing on gum, looking as cool as a cucumber. He's got a little bit of time to wait.
Now in a few moments we will start the bronze medal match.
Bronze medal match coming up. And in the meantime, the crowd here can just enjoy the sunshine. He won't be enjoying the sunshine. You got a feel for Maxime Motte. He was looking so good. This is how it lines up. Motte and Fernandez, bronze medal match, is the first up here in this fabulously appointed Trap on Verde, 93 nations here. Record for the range. And it's a range that's only been here since 1982. So it's grown and grown and kept growing, and it is a fabulous, fabulous facility. Just shotgun, no indoor shooting here. But 12 ranges. It's a long old stretch, isn't it, if you have to go from 1 to 12.
It's the biggest shooting range in Italy. It's really
one of the biggest in the world, of course,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, and
here we are, a real
hotbed of shooting. A lot of gun manufacturers around here as well, and they're here in force as well. So then, Motte against Fernandez at the moment for our bronze medal match. And the big question, I think it's fair to say, is can Motte, who you saw on the left-hand side of our shot, just get himself together? He was 88th, we mentioned, at last year's World Championship. So whatever happens, he's done really well. But it'll take a bit of getting over the fact that he was two ahead going into the last few shots. Looked like he was going to get into that gold medal match, where whatever happens, you get a medal of some colour. Now here,
so he
could still go away.
He's just 24 years old.
Yeah, go away with nothing. Fourth is a painful place to be in these championships. That will settle his nerves.
Nice start.
15 targets again, of course. It's a shot in five sections of three.
Yeah, correct.
Ready.
Oh, yeah, some shooting in the background. The other range is still busy. Qualification for the double trap tomorrow. We have several more days of action here as these two fight it out, shoot it out for a place on the podium. It's a tough old job being a coach, especially when things aren't going your way. Belgium national coach is Luc Butt. And whatever happens, Motte, when you reflect, will be proud of his performance today. Got a place at Rio, that's half the battle as well in this year preceding the Olympic Games, and at the moment, 3 out of 3 for both of these athletes. Of course, I don't know whether you practice for these sort of finals, but it's very different to qualification, very different to the semi-final.
Yeah, I told you, for example, Fernandez entering this semi-final with the highest score, and now he's doing for the bronze medal match. And he missed one target now.
Yeah, 123. It was a couple of shots ahead of anybody else, a couple of targets ahead.
Come on, you do all the competition, you enter with the highest score, you say, come on, I can do it. No.
It really is just what happens during that very intense final, of course, and Motte will testify to that. Motte, who was the sixth to qualify with 120. Varga also had 120, and that was the cut-off, no shoot-off, and yet he looked like he was going to sail into the gold medal match. He's not, but he is in the medal match, and he is ahead at the moment. And he was looking good all the way through, wasn't he, until the last couple of shots. So let's hope that he can continue looking as composed as he is at the moment. He's edged ahead by just one, still yet to drop a shot in this bronze medal match. Motte to start us again. His seventh shot. And that might, yes, it was a miss. Way to the right.
Six and six.
And the shots, of course, is in these medal matches, a little bit more predictable than you're finding in the semi-final. Doesn't stop them missing, of course, under these pressurized situations.
Yeah, I think it's a little bit scary. The game.
If your heartbeat is racing, then it's hard to control it. And there's another miss from Fernandez, a man from Madrid. World rank 21. He's certainly higher of the two in terms of ranking, 57 for Motte. And as I say, he is the World Champion from 2010. This man, though, best he's ever managed is a silver European Championship Junior event 7 years ago now. So this is a big thing for Morte. And he's ahead again after that second miss from Fernandez. Be a coach, nervous, nothing you can do now. Sit and watch and hope for the best. Well, he's had one miss, but put it behind him nicely, Motte.
Oh.
Nice shot.
Totally in control there. Fernandez responding well.
Motte at 9, Fernandez 8. They're so close.
Well, when you are this close, I mean, some medal matches, we do see one athlete having a terrible, torrid time. And it's all done by now. Not very often. More often than not, it's like this. And remember, if it is tied and there is a miss, if it is tied at the end, then we will go to a shoot-off.
And, sorry, Motte.
Motte will not be wanting to countenance that just yet. And the sun has just gone behind, partially behind a cloud. Still quite bright, but certainly a little bit duller than a few minutes ago.
Oh!
That's better. He's holding his own at the moment. Well, Motte ahead, that miss from Fernandez. A little bit confusing because you saw the puff of the smoke, but that was from the previous shot from the Belgian athlete. So, Motte. It's the slight advantage, but we do know that Motte has form when it comes to the last series of shots. Only three, of course, now, not the five. So he's already up.
He's missing more targets here in the semi-final than in all the competition on qualification.
Absolutely, yeah.
Oh.
It's the pressure element, isn't it? But that's excellent.
Oh.
Must hit from Fernandez. Well. Worst comes to worst for Motte, it's going to be a shoot-off. If he nails this one, he has the bronze medal.
Yeah. Ready. One shot for the bronze.
Back of his mind, he'll know that he can actually afford to miss this and hit again, but he won't want to do it.
Oh.
That'll do it.
Yeah. Here we are.
Excellent work.
Motte bronze medal match. Oh. And Fernandez, fourth place. Whoa. It's what happened?
We'll go until the end of the 15, of course. It's difficult for the athletes who know what's happened. Pellielo getting ready for the gold medal match, just standing up in front of our scoreboard. But we can see on the screen that it's all done and dusted.
Oh.
And the last shots from these athletes. Academic, excellent work from Motte.
Oh.
He will be so delighted after that disappointment of dropping out of the gold medal match. Fernandez, it's not going to be a medal World Championships for him. The two bearded men shake, and the celebrations for Belgium and the Belgian coach can start. That's nice, isn't it? Excellent work. The man, 88th at last year's World Championship, takes the bronze here, and that's a lovely story.
Yeah.
And Fernandez, fourth for him. Well, just wasn't his day.
It's a little bit sad, but it's normal.
Topping qualification, but as you say, it doesn't mean anything when you scrub to nothing and start the semi-final. Let's see confirmation of that. Motte with the bronze. And next up, our gold medal match between Slovakia and, well, he'll have the majority of the home fans behind him, of course. Giovanni Pellielo of Italy. Well, we'll be hearing the Italian national anthem. Again, we heard it yesterday for the women's junior.
Yeah.
One of your teammates was up there on the podium enjoying her moment. It was amazing, wasn't it?
Yeah, really amazing.
Managed to speak to her?
Yeah.
And what was she saying?
She said, good job. Something more? Something else? Come on.
Well, lots of Italian athletes here, a lot of Italian support, and these seats were full up to half an hour before, and they are also standing on the concourse, four or five deep as well. So, huge success for the organisers. We are just awaiting the athletes and the presentation for this gold medal match here in the World Championships.
Here we are.
And here we are. Eric Varga of Slovakia, hugely experienced, of course. And, listen to the cheers for the homeboy. 45 years of age now. Well, he went through all his achievements, but he is a double silver medalist at the Olympic Games and a four times world champion. 2 years ago, the last time in Lima. Two very experienced athletes. Varga, actually world ranked 48 at the moment to the 39-year-old, but he is the current world champion from Granada last year. So just going down on the left-hand side of these athletes.
Let's start.
Yeah, right, let's get on with it. The organizers will be keen because we have the junior men's competition after this. So do stay with us here on ISSF TV because it's a great opportunity for the juniors. You've enjoyed being involved with the seniors around as well.
Of course.
Do you feel you learn a lot?
It's amazing to see the champion that they are stood before you. You can learn a lot of things.
Oh. Well, someone here is going to be a champion, but it won't be Varga if he keeps missing. Just a second shot. Pellielo, all the weight of his home country. Well, seems to sit pretty lightly on his shoulders. The coach, as always,
always
quick to show his emotions.
They're always sad, man.
Oh.
No target. What happened?
No target.
No target.
The referee just calling you back
he
again.
Must repeat the target.
Yeah, I think you're probably right there. It's showing as a hit on our scoreboard, but.
Ready.
Oh, it's Yanatis Heraculus, our referee. You can see in the background there.
Oh!
Nice shot.
Yeah, certainly was. Nicely done by Varga. Pellielo. Bit of a brute there, and the red flags go up. So it's equal at the moment. Two. Morte able to sit down and relax, knowing that he has the bronze medal. The presentations will be after the junior event is over. That comes straight after this one, but this is the main event, of course, deciding who will be world champion. Sometimes we do end up in these finals in shoot-off. They can go very long.
Especially the shoot-off.
And especially when it's trapped. It's double trap, a few more variables, ski again. Not quite so easy to bag them.
Whoa, another miss.
Well, we weren't expecting this in the final. Two such experienced athletes. I just wonder whether it's so through the conditions. There's not a huge amount of wind, is there?
The light is not good. You can see the target when it starts. It's so difficult to take.
When you say it's difficult, why? Because the sun is away to the left?
Yeah. Because the sun is at the left, and you don't see the left target when they start. You stay there and say, where is the target?
And you have to chase it.
Oh gosh, it's the target is there.
And some very often it's the target going away to your left that is causing problems.
Yeah. In the first few seconds, you didn't see him.
And I presume it would be certain stations would be more difficult for us than others.
I think the both of the position is difficult.
Well, six gone out of 15. And it is the Italian who has his nose ahead. 5-4 against Eric Varga. Varga, a chance to be back-to-back world champion here. What a story that would be.
Yeah.
But he's got a bit of work to do here. He has to hope that Pellielo slips up once, possibly twice.
And it's funny to see that John Pellielo won the gold medal match in Lima, and Varga won last year.
They've been handing it back to each other.
Yeah.
2013 gold for Pellielo in Lima. 2014 gold for Varga, who has also won the Junior World Championship as well. So he has the full set. All Varga.
So enjoy.
Absolutely. Wow. All Varga would like to say is I've got it back again. And given the huge amount of athletes, I mean, overall, over the whole week, there's 800, but there are it's a big field to come through, not only qualification, but also the semi-final, to find yourself in once again. In the gold medal match, in Varga's case, after a shoot-off.
Yeah, but the same target of the shoot-off.
He's missed again, and this gives a chance to Pellielo just to open up a bit of a lead here. 8-6 at the moment, and no wonder the Italian coach is looking a little bit more relaxed.
No.
No, never.
I know him, no, never. Until the last target, he's always like this.
Come the last target, and his man is the world champion, he may be jumping up and down, we'll see.
Yeah.
There's a long way to go. Still, if I can keep hitting, you never know. Pellielo, though, with the advantage. Oh. Nicely done.
Still.
That's the left-hander you don't like very much.
Ready.
Chassis with a very personalised preparation. Towards the stage where Varga knows that Pellielo has to stop missing if he's to have a chance at the gold. Still a 2-point cushion for the Italian. Is that lady on the phone? That gentleman's texting. I'm not sure what the dog's doing on that lady's lap. Probably trying to keep away from the noise.
Ready.
Well, I can assure you virtually everybody else is glued to this competition. Oh. Varga doing what he has to do now. He's hit the last three, as you can see.
And hope.
And hope is all he can do, you're right. But Pellielo is looking good. Just one out of three to ensure at least a shoot-off. And there are VIPs. Representative, as the General Secretary, rather, of the ISSF there. And Schreiber enjoying the action like we all are in the late afternoon sunshine. Heading towards 6 o'clock local time. Temperature has certainly dropped in the last hour. Oh, and a miss. Now then.
An important miss.
Yes.
Seriously.
Absolutely. Still in a good position. Still one shot ahead.
Yeah.
But we have two shots left, and Varga just has to keep hitting and hoping, and he has.
Yeah.
That's that left-hander again that we were saying is the difficult one in towards the sunshine. Pressure on Pellielo then.
Oh.
He's seen it all before. Okay. That's better. So then
until the last target.
Varga has to hit and hopes Pellielo misses, and then we go to a shoot-off.
See here, speak again. And again and again.
Ready.
Oh. And it's a hit from Varga. Pellielo then, this to become world champion for an incredible fifth time.
Oh,
it's a miss, and hands on head in front of us. People can hardly believe it. Neither can the coach.
I told you.
Goodness me, what an exciting denouement to this gold medal match. It goes to a shoot-off.
Yeah, again. This is what can happen in the semifinals.
You know the coach, what will you be saying, do you think?
I think, don't worry, relax. You know that you can break every target. Relax and break.
Well, the sun.
Believe in yourself.
Absolutely. The sun has kind of hidden itself behind a bit of light cloud away on the horizon. To our left.
So difficult now, because I think in the mind of Johnny Pellielo there is, why I missed the last one? why I missed this target, why I missed this one. It's not easy.
It is something you've got to put to the back of your mind, but that is a lot easier to say than to do.
You have to leave your mind in another place.
Yeah, just try and rely on the mechanics. So, here we go then, first one to miss, and it's the first one to have to accept the silver medal. Unless they both missed the same round. Both hitting the first ones.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know whether that's a look of calm or... Ready. It's hard to say. These guys try and hide behind their shades and not let anyone know what they're feeling.
Good.
It's getting increasingly difficult to see.
Yeah.
In the darkness. Ready. It's not very dark, but it's certainly getting darker. It gets dark about 8 o'clock. It's
but it's dark.
It's just getting it's been worse, that's for sure. Pellielo needs to get this one.
Oh,
and it's a miss.
You miss.
It's a miss. And from being ahead right towards the end of the gold medal match, that last gas miss took him to the shoot-off. And Pellielo, in all sorts of drama, has to wait for this and have to take the silver medal. Eric Varga, back-to-back champion. Well, what a great battle between these two. And all the celebrations are for the Slovakian. Well, what a competition that was.
Whoa, really incredible.
There we are, confirmation that Eric Varga takes the gold medal.
Again?
The current world champion stays the world champion, and what an amazing feat that is. And, you have to feel for Giovanni Pellielo and for the crowd. They couldn't believe what had happened. And. He's been and seen and done everything. He has 4 gold medals already. He looked like he was going to take a 5th, but it just didn't happen. Pellielo with the silver, and a good day's work all the same for the man from Vercelli. Crowd will hang around for the junior final, I am sure. But here's confirmation of our medalists. And what an excellent, excellent afternoon shooting it's been. Well, we say here are our medalists. I think we're just waiting for Pellielo to make his way through his fans back down. As you can see, a lot of people here at the Trap Conca Verde here in Lonato in northern Italy. And Pellielo will take his time. He will be more than happy to talk to all his fans here. They love him. They love the Italian shooting team. I know, Fiametta, you know that as well. But there we are, finally, I think we have the lineup of our medalists here in the men's trap competition. Just a confirmation that Maxime Motte took bronze. It was silver for the home favourite, Giovanni Pellielo, and gold for Slovakia. And for a second year in a row, for Eric Varga.
This silver medal representing Italia goes to Giovanni Pellielo. And the gold medal representing Slovakia goes to Eric Varga.
Vai a destra dove c'è camera, vai a destra. Vai a destra. Avvicinati, avvicinati che mi dai i fiori.
Thank you. again, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for national anthem of Slovakia. We congratulate the winners on the Trap Men's event. Please stick with us as we will now continue with the Trap Men's Team Event Award Ceremony. Thank you. Okay.